I'm going to show you how to make the most incredible roast chicken like you've never had. Crispy skin, juicy meat, melt in your mouth. We're going to have Hasselback potatoes, sweet onions, butternut squash. We're going to make a salsa verde, and it's all going to happen in here. The classic Weber master touch. So don't think about your Sunday roast, think about your Sunday grilled chicken. So let me show you how you can set this up to happen really quickly, in the same time as you would preheat your regular oven, right? So this is the chimney starter, and I kind of three-quarter filled it with some natural briquettes. So we're about 5 minutes in, and around 12, 13 minutes, that's gonna be ready and raring to go. That is enough time for me to show you what I'm gonna do with this incredible chicken. I'm gonna have a little tray here with some onions and some beetroots. So skin on the onions, skin on the beetroots, and frankly, any roast vegetables. So this is gonna go down the bottom. So super, super simple. Secondly, I wanna have some fun with roast potatoes. So I'm gonna do a Hasselback potato. So I've got like 6 spuds here. Just get yourself some spoons, lay them down like that, put your potato in the middle like this, and then just take your time to cut down about like 0.5 centimeter through the potato like that. This is an amazing little hack because these spoons protect you cutting all the way through the potatoes. So when you kind of do cut through, you get this amazing concertina effect. Look at that. Then you can get seasoning in there, oils, herbs, and then all the lovely smokiness from the barbecue. It's gonna be amazing. So in no time at all, we'll just slice through these potatoes like that. Then we've got our lovely carrots. So just take the ends off these, just give them a wash. So we got our veggies. Now, let me show you this clever little gadget that the Weber gang have done, right? This is basically the poultry roaster. And it's brilliant because you've got this cage, you've got the holes, the smoke and the heat can get through there. You can roast veggies in there. You know, it's really, really clever. And what they've done is created an infusion cup here. This holds the chicken up. So it's standing there beautifully, getting roasted 360. You could do it with duck and turkey, but also you can put stuff in here. So I'm putting wine in here. You could put stock in there. You could put beer, cider in there. It doesn't matter. You can put herbs in there if you want. You can put citrus in there if you want. But as that chicken is roasting from the inside, it's steaming. That's gonna give you a kiss of flavor. It's gonna keep the chicken or the poultry really, really moist. So it's really clever cooking. So what we can do is get our veggies of your choice in here. We can get our Hasselback potatoes in here as well. We can have a little drizzle up of olive oil. And don't forget, there'll be fat coming off the chicken going around this. It's gonna be the best potatoes and veg ever. So just give that a little jiggle. I like to also get some nice salt and pepper going. With the seasoning, you can get that in the little cuts. So look, veggies are done. Now onto the chicken, a simple little preparation to really give it a beautiful kiss of flavor. So I'm gonna take a little bit of fennel seeds. You can use a nice spice of your choice if you wish. Salt, pepper, a little bit of rosemary as well. If you want to add a little bit of lemon zest, you can add that as well, just a little grating. And we're gonna pound that up and create a lovely flavored oil. So really fragrant. So once you've given that a nice little pound, just drizzle in some olive oil. So look, I'm muddling now. And once you've got enough oil in there, what I can do is pour it over this chicken. So this is a nice big 1.8 chicken. So you can feed a few people with that. Just pour that flavored oil over the chicken like that. And then we're gonna use our hands to rub that all over the chicken. All the little cracks and crannies. There's no polite way to do this. Get the flavor in there. Now, we can take this chicken and slip it onto the infusion cup. What it's gonna do is hold the chicken up, and that's gonna steam this beautiful chicken, keeping it moist and delicious while it roasts and gets crispy on the outside. Now, with this sort of end of the chicken here, we can stuff that in with some herbs, no worries. Little wedge of lemon, and that will keep even more steaming. Right, let me wash my hands, and then let's get this barbecue ready to roast. Right, clean hands, let's get these gloves on. Now, let me show you how to get these coals, sort of transforming this barbecue, which I know many people will be sort of direct grilling, burgers, sausages, all that good stuff, but we're gonna turn this into an oven. So we're gonna do the indirect method. So down here, if I can just show you, we've got, you know, beautiful coals. Look, they've gone nice and gray, right? They've had about 13, 14 minutes, so super quick. We've got these rails here. So I'm just gonna put half on one side, like that, and half on this side. Put that somewhere away safe. So we've got 2 channels here of the natural briquettes. They're gonna last for like 3 hours, right? So that's fantastic. When the lid's on, the heat goes up and turns this into an oven. Very, very cool. But what we have here is like a safe zone. So I'm gonna use that because I wanna use every little bit of this barbecue. I'll put that tray with the onions and the beets, and you can put a little swig of water in here as well if you want, just to create a little bit of humidity. Poultry roaster goes on. Let's prep this squash. Really, really simple. It's round, so be careful. Nice little sort of chunks like that. And then when you kind of get to the part where you can see the core is gonna be, we can cut that like that in half. The seeds you can keep or you can remove, no worries at all. So you can use a little spoon. And I'm just gonna slice these into nice little sort of 1.5 centimeter pieces as well. Just a little olive oil and salt and pepper. And then we can take some of this and put it on these bars here, and they're gonna roast up beautifully as the chicken cooks. The lid now goes on top, and you're gonna see this temperature go up to 200 degrees Celsius really quickly. Okay, so a couple of minutes, right? So what we have is an air vent here. Make sure it's not locked down, right? Open it up so the airflow is coming out. Here we've got some little hickory or fruit wood chips. It doesn't matter what you use. Just soak it in a little bit of water. I've even put some rosemary in there as well. This will give that beautiful sort of smoky wood flavor. So I'll just take that off, put these little flaps up at the side, and then take some of those wood chips and lay those on top, and they're gonna smell absolutely incredible. Imagine all of that roasting together, right? It's not gonna be boring. So now I've had a nice little clean down, I wanna show you how to make a classic sauce that you can have with roasted meats and grilled meats. It's got that incredible sort of hit of little gherkins, that piquance, that tang, capers, just a little bit like that. So half a clove of garlic is all you need. I'm gonna use some nuts. You could have almonds. I'm gonna use some walnuts today. It could be hazelnuts. You can mix up the nuts. Anchovies, really, really important. You're gonna get that lovely umami flavor. Not loads of them, just a couple. And then herb-wise, you can go from parsley, mint, basil. So we're gonna use the cross-chopping method. What I'm gonna do first is just go through the anchovies, the gherkins, and the capers. When it's kind of fine, we can then bring in our herbs and just slice through it. And just use this knife just to sweep it back into the middle again. At this stage, get yourself a little bowl, and I'll take all these wonderful herbs, put them in there. We're gonna loosen it with some olive oil and about a tablespoon of white or red wine vinegar. Then we're gonna turn this into a beautiful salsa with the help of a little Dijon mustard. So that goes in. So salsa verde done. Now, let's have a little check of our chicken. We're halfway cooked on this chicken, 45 minutes. Have a look at that, come on! Right, what I love to do now is get a couple of bits of herb, rosemary, get down the bottom where the fat is rendering and really get it into all those hasselbacks, into the cuts. Check your squash, and if anything's catching, you can kind of move it around and rotate it. Lid back on, let it cook for another 45 minutes. When it's had its hour and a half, right, we'll just keep an eye on the temperature, obviously, get it up to 200 again. I'll let that chicken rest, we'll carve it, serve it, and it's gonna be utterly joyful. So the chicken's had an hour and a half. Let's have a look. Absolutely fantastic, look at that. Sizzling away, right. So what we're gonna do now is just remove these fantastic squash in and around our board here. I'm gonna use this little thermometer here. I push it in to the thickest part of the chicken, and you wanna get it up to 75 degrees. Internal temperature, 76 there, so we're perfect. Let's just get our beautiful chicken out. Look at this. Oh, the juices and the smells are amazing. Look at that chicken. And then let's get this off, and let's get all these beautiful veggies in and around this chicken. Look, we've got the carrots. Look at these little hasselbacks. They're so cool. So veggies are out. We've also got these onions and beets in here. If I just get these tongs, I can squeeze out from the inside the sweet, incredible inside. Look at that. So a pile of onions here. Then with the beets, we can just slice these up. Look at the color on the inside. Give these little sliced up bits of beets a little salt and pepper, a little olive oil. Now that, my friends, is a beautiful roast dinner. Imagine popping that down on a Sunday lunch. And with the salsa verde, you can just do little bits around that beautiful roasted squash here. People are gonna go crazy. So there you go, my roast chicken on the Weber. Such a beautiful thing. Let's get a stack of plates. Let's get a fork. And let's have a little carve up. What I like about using those thermometers is it does take all the fear away from is the chicken cooked or not. Then you can just have a little carb up, take a little bit of everything. So let's just finish that with a little bit of salsa verde. Let's have a little try. I'm gonna go for the chicken and a bit of beets and some salsa verde. My lord, the chicken is juicy. The skin has got that hit of smoke, which is really, really good. And I never thought I could get so much flavor out of a beetroot, just roasting it in that dry heat underneath the chicken. Amazing. And that smell that you get from the herbs and the wood chips, it's really on there, like a seasoning, it's in it. So, so good. And what I love is all of this comes from here, cooking under the chicken, around the chicken, and you get that 360 roast, which is so good. But that kiss of smoke and the herb is phenomenal. It's a roast chicken, but next level. So there you go, guys. My gorgeous roast chicken with the salsa verde and veggies. For more gorgeous barbecue recipes or to get yourself a Weber barbecue, go to weber.com.